Hey everyone, this is the next video in our series about API Gateway in microservices, which in this video series we are using Netflix Joule library that is provided by Netflix, right? So in this video we are going to talk about the security, how we can implement the security at the level of API Gateway, right? So let's go ahead and see what we have covered so far. So this is the playlist on YouTube that I have created, right? So these are the different topics that we have covered so far. You can go through it. And this is the page for source code that we are pushing, and this is the table of contents and all the topics in detail that we are covering, right? So this is authentication and security that we are going to cover here in this topic, right? So let's move ahead to the example part, right? So this is the application that we are talking about in whole series, right? This is the API gateway, and these are the individual services that we are accessing through this portal, right? So we do not have to know the address of these, we just have to know the route how to access that, right? So we're going to configure the application security at this point of time, at this point, right? So let's move to the app demo part and I'll show you the code. So this is the build.gradle of our Docker portal gateway application, right? So this is for the starter actuator, and this is the API gateway starter Netflix Joule, and this is the only dependency that I have added in this video, right, for the purpose of starter security, right? After adding this starter security, you have some jars and libraries. After this, what you have to do, you have to create a class file, right? A configuration for security. You have to configure the security, right? So this is the class file that I have created. I have extended this class with this web security configurator adapter, right? So let me go to this class and show you some things, right? So this is the documentation, provides a convenient base class for creating a web security configurator, right? Means you can configure the security here at this point of right. So these are the different methods that it has. You can override to define your configuration, right? So the same thing that I have done here. So I am overriding the one method, which is configure, which is taking argument HTTP security, right? Using this HTTP, this has different methods, right? Authorize request, it is authorizing the request based on the following configuration that you will provide, right? And matches, it is matching the path, whatever URL that you are giving here, it is going to match that. And what you want to do with those URLs that are matching with this and matcher, right? I want to authenticate that, right? So if you go to the documentation of this method, you can see specify that URLs are allowed by any authenticated user, right? So what the URLs were configured at this point of time are allowed to access. Without authentication, they are not allowed. Apart from this, any request that is coming, permit all. So only this route is secured at this point of time. All other are freely accessible, right? So this is the for fun part. I have just to show you how we can configure. So Spring security is in itself a big topic, right? So in future, I'm going to cover that, right? So for the basic purpose, I have configured this simple security, right? So let's start this portal gateway application and access the endpoints that it has, right? So when you are writing this class security config, do not forget to initialize this by using add configuration or creating the instance of the security config, right? So this is the only way that your application has instance of the security config. Okay. So if you see if you are adding the security dependencies, you can see the different security password and all other stuffs related to the security in the log file of the startup application, right? While your application is starting. So the application is running now. Let me move ahead and access these endpoints that we have. What endpoints we have? Application YAML. So we have doctor service, patient and disease services, right? So we are going to access these. So I have configured this doctor service to be accessed only when authenticated. All other are freely accessible, right? 810 and doctor services, what expectation is here? Access should not be allowed. It should not be able to access the URLs, right? So go ahead and see this. It is allowing. Let me see the code and see what is wrong. Okay. So we have configured here patient services, right? So patient services will be blocked, right? All other will be allowed access, right? So it is behaving the way we wanted, right? So we have configured here patient service to be secured, right? Next, go ahead and access that one, and it should throw an exception, right? We have patient services and it will throw exception. And what exception is this? Access denied, forbidden, right? Because it is not, we have not inserted the security parameters that it expected, right? So that is part of another video. I have not explained that, but allowed or not allowed, I have covered here, right? So you can configure here to permit all. If I'm not giving this parameter here, so if I comment this and start this, all the requests will be allowed to pass, right? Because it is permitting all the requests, and it has one method, deny all. In this case, it will deny to access all the services that are configured with this API gateway. And in some situation, we need these ones. So your application is compromised and there are data breach and all these things. At that point of time, you need to block all the services that are configured with the API gateway. So this is the best way that you can do, right? So this is the basic one about security config that you can do, right? So I'll post the code on GitHub at this page, right? So this authentication, basic authentication, is covered in future videos. I'll create the series of videos about covering about different security things that are there with the Spring Boot, right? So you can do that. So if you know security, you can apply those in this particular service, right? So it will be honored, right? Next, in API gateway is the turn for the Spring Cloud Gateway that is there, right? So if you remember the first video introduction about the API gateway, we talked about the Netflix Joule and also Spring Cloud Gateway, right? So Netflix Joule for the basic things are covered till now, right? So if any advanced things or anything is missed, I'll cover the in the next videos, future videos, or suggest me if you want to look into some other things, right? So next I'm going to prepare the Spring Cloud Gateway and I'll upload the videos when those are ready, right? What next you are going to get from this channel after this, right? So I'm working on the PCF, Pivotal Cloud Foundry, which is for the deployment, and the things content is almost ready, right? So that is why I'm going to upload that, and then we will talk about the Spring Cloud Gateway, right? So just to brief you what topics we are going to cover under that. So this is the Pivotal Cloud Foundry. So we will cover everything about that, introduction, environment setup, and you can mark this, you can star this repository, and you will see the videos when I am uploading and the code when I am pushing into it, right? So you can subscribe to the channel and see the notification. And don't worry, Spring Cloud Gateway, I am preparing that content. When that is ready, I'll upload that also, right? So I'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care, bye bye.